White nationalism, no biggie abroad or at home, says our president. My next guest disagrees. He's a former skinhead who now works to help people leave that life. His name is Christian Picciolini. Welcome to Primetime. Thank you for taking the opportunity.
Thanks, Chris.
So, Christian, tell me, what got you into it and what got you out of it?
You know, I came from a normal family, much like the manifesto said that that person did. My parents loved me, but I felt very abandoned by them. So at 14 years old in 1987, after being bullied for much of that period, somebody gave me a narrative that I latched onto and offered me a sense of identity, community, and purpose that I couldn't find anywhere else. And because I had that abandonment issue, because I had that trauma, that sense of loss, I was already on the margins, and they knew exactly where to look for me.
So the hate is a function of fragility. It's not something that was just inside of you. You didn't have a rationale to make enemies or demonize others.
No, I was, you know, my parents are Italian immigrants who came over to the U.S. in the mid-60s. They were often the victims of prejudice. So racism wasn't part of my family DNA. Instead, what I found out many, many years later, and I've seen this now with hundreds, if not thousands of people, is that the hatred really is self-hatred being projected outward, that it's everybody's broken. We're all broken. But people who are on the fringes, you know, may have felt marginalized. They may be broken. They may be dealing with mental health disorders. They may be dealing with poverty or even privilege issues. These are all things I call potholes, those things that appear in our life's journey that deviate our path. They detour us.
Gotcha.
And as we're looking for identity, community, and purpose, there's somebody out there on the fringes that will scoop people who are vulnerable up.
How'd you get out?
Oh, you know, it was receiving compassion from the people that I least deserved it from at a time when I least deserved it. I started to have meaningful interactions with the people I thought I hated for the first time. And at 23 years old in 1996, I found my way out. And even though I was quiet for a couple of years after that, in 2000, I started to really talk about this problem that we're now seeing today. And for 20 years, I've been warning over and over about this issue that it is going to get worse before.
It's just discreet. It's just fringe. Yeah, they kill people every once in a while, but it's nothing like the threat that we face from Islam, and it's nothing like we face from immigrants. I mean, we're hearing all of this talk. You believe it defies the reality.
Listen, this is the reality. 19 people flew two planes into the World Trade Centers and other buildings that day. One person took down the Oklahoma City bombing building. You know, we hear about these murders all the time, from the Tree of Life synagogue to, you know, to now the mosque. This is happening almost on a weekly, monthly basis, and goes underreported in many cases. And I see these incidents happen because I'm in this world. I help people disengage from it. And I can tell you that this has been going back for, you know, 30 years from when I was involved, where we had rallies like Charlottesville, and our intention was to provoke violence at those rallies. And our intention was to create this lone wolf culture that we're seeing, because we knew that as skinheads, we were pushing away even the average American white racist. And we were too edgy for them, and we started to mainstream the ideology. And this is the result of that effort.
So you believe that the internet is a turbocharging element, that it's on the rise. Let me ask you something. Why do these people like what the president says?
Well, because he says exactly what they're saying. And there's things that I said exactly.
But he says all the time, I'm not a white supremacist.
Words.
But Christian, just to give him his due, he'll say, I don't like these people. I'm not about them. I'm not about their cause. He doesn't say it right away. He often has to be pushed. But what do they believe?
Well, I can tell you that most white supremacists will also deny the fact that they're white supremacists in public, too. You know, and today when I heard him say that he thought it was a fringe issue, that he didn't think it was a problem, you know, I have to believe that he truly believes that, that he doesn't see a significant portion of some of the people that voted for him are white nationalists. So maybe he doesn't actually see it as a problem, as a threat.
Mm. And what do you think, when you say he says what they say, what exactly? What do they cling on to? Because we have seen an uptick in mouthiness among those who used to realize they were relegated to the shadows. What is it that they're grabbing onto?
Well, I can tell you 30 years ago, I used to call for a wall to be built or for illegal immigrants to be taken out of the country, all immigrants who weren't white to be taken out of the country. I called, for the U.S. To pull out of partnerships in Europe. It was all about the breakdown of democracy. And what's happening now is being aided by a foreign influence. So we're seeing, the foundation rippers come in from Eastern Europe and from Russia with the propaganda that's being flooded all over the internet. What's happening on the internet is it is essentially a 24-hour hate buffet. It is that alley I was standing in at 14 years old and had to have a person physically connect with me to recruit me. What's happening now is people are going to this buffet and they can feast all night long on message forums that are not even geared towards white nationalism. What's happened is the recruiters have gotten devious, even more devious, and they're going to places that are safe places online, like depression forums, autism forums. They're talking to our youngest kids over their multiplayer headsets to recruit them. This is what's happening now. They're trying to push a false narrative that's based on conspiracy theory that, frankly, is hard to not step into on the internet.
Got to call it out. Got to call it out everywhere we see it. Christian, good for you trying to get other people out of a jam that you found your way into. And good luck with the rest of your life. Thank you for talking to us about this.
Thanks, Chris.